First day of practice, first official day of practice. I know you've been working all summer, but what'd you think of your first day?
Well, it's tough with the weather, but we were able to execute some things. We've been out here all summer working on a lot of different drills and this is the first state official, but our district allows us to start on Thursday. So our JVs and varsity has been out for 3 days. Today we added the 45 freshmen. So a lot of learning, a lot of kids, you know, learning the system, getting used to what's going on. But by and large, considering the rain, considering the practicing in the gym and off, getting out of the wet field, I think the kids did a great job.
How about your learning curve? You were at Holy Cross and before that Bishop Eustis. Public school's a little bit different, and it's a bigger school than you're used to. What's the learning curve been for you?
Well, I've been around since February, and the good thing is, kids are kids. I had great kids at Eustis, I had great kids at Holy Cross, and I got the kids I've met here have been great. Football, I'm coaching football kids. It doesn't matter whether you're in a public school, Catholic school, private school, it's still football kids. You got kids who want to do well, kids that are tough kids that work hard. Ever since I walked in the door, we've been doing a great job in the weight room, getting speed, agility, and getting conditioned, and it's just putting it all together on the football field.
Heard you guys mention 9-9. That's obviously your first game. How close are you where you need to be?
We're at day four. One step at a time. We talk to the kids about getting better every time we walk on the field. I think we're a better football team than we were yesterday. Fortunately, today it's the 15th. It's not the 8th. Okay. So we have every step. We have one day at a time, and we get better as a football team every time we come out here.
You've been around this area a long time. Lenape's got a lot of talented kids, a lot of good potential football players. What do you see as the future?
If we keep the intensity, and that's what we got to do. I mean, football, you know, you can talk about what could be and the talent here, the talent there. Football's about intensity. It's about really wanting to play well and play for 48 minutes. What the kids have shown, you know, we're going to fight. We're going to fight for 48 minutes. We're going to play tough defense. We're going to play sound fundamental football. We're going to do the things we need to do, and we'll let the other things take care of themselves.
How are the kids reacting to a new group of coaches? You kept a couple of guys, but a lot of new faces out there.
I'm fortunate. Two or three guys that I kept from the previous staff have done a great job, and then some of the other guys that I've had in my old staff joined us, and then I've sprinkled in a couple other two, three new fresh faces. The kids have responded well. Everybody's working hard. I mean, it's evident today we're in a parking lot, and the kids are all 120 kids busting their butt during conditioning and team offense in a parking lot. So they want to learn. They're hungry. They're like sponges. They want to win, they want to learn, but they got to put in the work too to see what happens.
Day after Thanksgiving and maybe even later, how are you going to measure a successful season for this team?
Playing hard every game. Wins and losses, they take care of themselves. I want us to play hard and swing for 48 minutes. Heck, if we played Notre Dame or Florida State or Florida Gators every game, I'd want us to swing for 48 minutes. So it doesn't matter who we play, first game of the season, 10th game of the season. Every time we step on a football field, it's an opportunity to demonstrate what we're doing.